Welcome to Control Systems Tutorial Session. I am Jasmine Vijitra. Let's start the session. Today we will be discussing what are the types of control systems and what are the mathematical models of control systems and problems under mathematical models. So before going into this tutorial part, we will be defining what is a control system. So in order to define a control system, let us assume that we are having a system. The system is fed with the input R of t and we will be getting an output C of t. So if the output quantity is controlled by means of varying the input quantity, then it is called as a control system. The output quantity is controlled by means of the input quantity, then it is called as a control system. This control system can be broadly classified into two types. First one is open loop control system and the next one is closed loop control system. So let's see what is open loop control system. So in open loop control system, if the output has no effect on input quantity, then it is called as an open loop control system. That is, here we have an input, we will be feeding it into a system. This is called as a plant and you will get an output. So if you vary the input, there will be no impact on the output. You will get the output for the following input. So if the output has no effect on varying the input quantity, then it is called as an open loop control system. And the closed loop control system is, we'll explain this with the help of a diagram. That is, we are giving an input R of t to a system and we will be getting an output, and a part of an output is fed back to the input. So this is a feedback part. So the closed loop control system can be defined as, the output has an effect upon the input quantity in order to maintain a desired output value. The output has an effect upon the input quantity in order to maintain a desired output value. That is called as a closed loop control system. So the basic blocks of control system or the basic elements of control system is input R of t, error detector, plant, controller, feedback and output. These are the basic elements of control system. Next, we will be discussing mathematical models of control system. So it can be classified into two types, mechanical translational and mechanical rotational system. The basic elements of mechanical translational system is mass, dashpot and spring. Mass is represented using M, dashpot is B and spring is K. The symbolic representation of mass is this, and dashpot is, and spring is. Next is mechanical rotational system. The basic elements of mechanical rotational system is moment of inertia, dashpot, and spring. Moment of inertia is J, dashpot is B, and spring is K. And the symbolic representation is the same as mechanical translational system. In mechanical translational system deals with force, velocity, displacement. Force is represented using F, velocity is V, and displacement is X. Whereas the mechanical rotational system deals with torque, angular velocity and angular displacement. Torque is T, angular velocity is omega, and displacement, angular displacement is theta. Next, we will be seeing in detail about the mechanical translational system. So before that, let's see what is the definition of transfer function. So transfer function is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input with zero initial conditions. So transfer function is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input with the zero initial conditions. So in a system, if you are considering R of T as input and C of T as output, then transfer function is given as Laplace transform of output, that is C of T, divided by Laplace transform of input, that is R of T, with zero initial conditions. That is, Laplace transform of C of T is C of S and Laplace transform of R of T is R of S. Okay. So Laplace transform is used to convert a time domain signal to a S domain signal, a time domain signal to a frequency domain signal. Let's see in detail about mechanical translational system. So the symbols that we are using in mechanical translational system are as follows. Let X be the displacement, F be the force, V be the velocity, dx by dt is equal to V. That is, rate of change of displacement is called as velocity. This is the expression for velocity. And A is acceleration. The expression for acceleration is rate of change of velocity. That is dv by dt. In terms of displacement, this can be written as rate of change of velocity. Velocity is replaced by dx by dt. So this is equal to d square x by dt square. And next is F is called as the applied force. Fm is called as the opposing force. Opposing force, this M represents mass. So we can write it as opposing force offered by mass. Fb is opposing force offered by dashpot. Fk is opposing force offered by spring. Okay. M is mass, B is dashpot, and K is spring. So the symbols are X is displacement, V is velocity. The velocity expression is dx by dt. A is acceleration. Acceleration expression is d square x by dt square. F is the applied force. Fm is the opposing force offered by mass. Fb is the opposing force offered by dashpot. Fk is the opposing force offered by spring. M is mass, B is dashpot, and K is spring. In order to solve problems under mechanical translational system, we must know about Newton's second law. So what Newton's second law is, sum of applied force is equal to sum of opposing forces. So as in mechanical translational system, we know we have three basic elements, mass, dashpot, and spring. So we need to know the force expressions connecting to these three elements. Let's start force balancing equations for mechanical translational system. So the basic elements of mechanical translational system is mass, spring, and dashpot. Let's start writing with mass. The symbolic representation of mass is this. Now consider F of T, F is the applied force, or F of T is the applied force. So when we give an applied force to a mechanical system, it will automatically offer an opposing force. So the opposing force offered by mass is considered to be Fm. By Newton's second law, what we know is applied force is equal to opposing force, right? Let's consider x be the displacement. So how will we write this is, mass is directly related to or directly proportional to acceleration. So acceleration in terms of velocity is dv by dt. and in terms of displacement is d square x by dt square. Okay, so the opposing force Fm is given as m into d square x divided by dt square. Okay, so the opposing force offered by mass is m into d square x by dt square. Now we will be seeing for dashpot. Dashpot is represented using V, and the diagrammatic representation of dashpot is this. Let us consider Fb the applied force. So the dashpot will offer an opposing force Fb, and let x be the displacement. Now by Newton's second law, we can write this as applied force is equal to opposing force. Here dashpot is connected to velocity. So in terms of displacement, velocity can be written as dx by dt. So the opposing force exerted by dashpot is v into dx by dt. Okay. If we are considering two displacements, that is x1 and x2, and if F is the applied force, this dashpot will offer an opposing force Fb. So how we can write this expression for opposing forces? Fb is equal to v into d by dt of, we must write the first displacement minus the second displacement, that is x1 minus x2, if you are seeing on the input side. So if you are seeing on the output side, then the same expression can be written as b into d by dt of x2 minus x1. Okay, so next is spring. Spring is represented using the variable k, and the diagrammatic representation of spring is this. Let F be the applied force, let Fk be the opposing force offered by the spring, and x be the displacement. So by Newton's second law, what we know is applied force is equal to opposing force. Spring is directly proportional to displacement, so we can write the expression as kx. If we are considering two displacements, x1 and x2, then the expression for spring is written as Fk is equal to k into x1 minus x2. So if you are considering the output side as the first side, then the same expression can be rewritten as x2 minus x1. So the summary of this is, for mass, the opposing forces m into d square x by dt square, that is mass is proportional to acceleration, and for dashpot the opposing force expression is v into dx by dt, that is dashpot is proportional to velocity, and for spring the opposing force can be written as k into x, that is k is proportional to displacement. So if you have more number of displacements, you have to represent the displacement in terms of difference of two displacements. That's all. Let's see some formulas under Laplace transform. So this will be very helpful for you to solve the problems. So let's see the formulas. The first formula of Laplace transform is Laplace transform of an impulse function del of t is equal to 1. Laplace transform of an unit step function u of t is equal to 1 by s. Laplace transform of t is equal to 1 by s square. So in general we can write this as Laplace transform of t to the power n divided by n minus 1 the whole factorial is equal to 1 divided by s power n. Laplace transform of e power minus at is equal to 1 by s plus e. Laplace transform of t to the power n is equal to n factorial divided by sn plus 1. Laplace transform of tn into t to the power n into e power minus at is equal to 1 divided by s plus ad whole square. Laplace transform of sin omega t is equal to omega divided by s square plus omega square. Laplace transform of cos omega t is equal to s divided by s square plus omega square. Laplace transform of sin hat omega t is equal to omega divided by s square minus omega square. Laplace transform of cos h omega t is equal to s divided by s square minus omega square. Laplace transform of e power minus a t into sin omega t is equal to omega divided by s plus a the whole square plus omega square. And the last formula is Laplace transform of e power minus a t cos omega t is equal to s divided by s plus a the whole square plus omega square. So wherever sine comes, the numerator will be omega. Wherever cos comes, the numerator will be s. Please learn the formulas so that it will be helpful to solve the problems when the values are given in question paper. Laplace transform of differential equations can be given as Laplace transform of d by dt is s. Laplace transform of d square by dt square is s square. If it is like this, Laplace transform of dx by dt, then it is d by dt is s and Laplace transform of x is x of s. Laplace transform of y of t means y of s. Laplace transform of x of t means x of s. Laplace transform of d power n by dt power n is equal to s power n. So that's all about today's session. We will be discussing the problems based on mechanical translational system and force balancing equations in the forthcoming sessions. Thank you. Have a nice day.